there's a hot topic that we should be debating now. Is this related to policy? We'll open the conversation. We feel that there is a deficit on conversations about the is there to this is have that of our speakers. Project. And is on still appropriate at this the introductions of all of our speakers, and then I'm going to hand the floor to them to give us a technical introduction. I'm going to turn the floor over to aspects of leadership. I've been working aspect has been engaged share with with regard on the agenda today. Road. Join us here today. An expert on low Earth orbit satellites. We have asked Larry today. North America. So we will try to see what they are up to and if there is anything for us to be joined. We are also very recent for good. So that about care is a participant please, the floor is yours.
And that society we you know, we have this question around sports is a lot closer to the earth, and so it has less there's some in 300, there's a wide range of different areas. It's a crowded space. That's where the International Space Station synchronous orbit, which is for constellation orbiting the Earth. Looking at capacity. Petition. With each other. Is it later in so other colleagues here will I think Leo's
can you stop there? We cannot longer.
On site, we can't hear you.
I'm not sure. So, if on site, are you able to hear anyone?
Can you hear me?
No, you are back. No, you are back.
Dear IT. Now we are back. So, there was a glitch, I understand, with connectivity. Berna, would you kindly try and
restart
your apology again? Yeah,
okay.
We're on
okay,
the
I'll try
slide,
again.
So
no, I was just saying that. I'm glad to be following someone who has already explained the technical background for this new technology. Did a fantastic job. So, but you know, as legal scholars, the questions we are asked and the questions we think about are more along the lines of are states and private companies allowed to deploy as many satellites as they like? Who's controlling all this? Which authority is responsible? And is there any regulation? Is there any international coordination? So in the first part of my presentation, I'll provide a brief, you know, given the time of it, answers to these questions. And in the second part, I'll provide an overview of the response in the EU to the emergence of these new mega constellations. So can we move on to the third page, please? Okay, maybe I can. Okay, so the private enterprises undertaking these projects, such as SpaceX and Amazon Kuiper or OneWeb, are subject to a wide range of domestic laws and regulations, and in all phases of their operation. Most licensing and authorization procedures happen at the pre-launch phase, and rules and regulations about the in-orbit phase are primarily an extension of the oversight and control responsibility of the states. One example for this is the in-orbit tracking for purposes of traffic management to avoid collision. Agents of the operation of satellite services, but of course this all depends have obtained all necessary licenses and authorizations, and they are in orbit, and they have answer is yes and no. Broadband these ground stations. They will also need to obtain license to use the frequency space. Will also or the importation of their user terminals will also be likely to be subject to import service providers based on national security grounds. So the LEO satellite constellations to fulfill their promise as they need to be discussed by all the relevant stakeholders at domestic level. So can we move on to the slide, please? Thank you. So there are all these rules and regulations imposed by national authorities, but do states have complete freedom for their regulatory authority? And yes, and international telecommunications regulation. I'll try to. Okay, thank you. So I'll start. Use freedom of exploration. principles underlying these treaties. The deployment of satellites over the years by an increasing number of states have been based on the understanding. And register this. Associated with the state and their liability regimes. There's a recent example in the US, FCC recently voted to review the previous The US aims to space also of utmost importance. Which is another Internet. Intended to. This registration is important. From harmful interference. The global. Nations. Well, the ITU doesn't stop there. Its role is to also ensure that these resources are used rightly and economically. They didn't require coordination among nations, but as the IT is between private nation in a management of spectrum and associated orbital resources was instrumental, and I think frequencies. Okay, so consulate.
is a fundamental regulation in place that deals with the use of outer space. Services like SpaceX and Starlink, but that's not the only. And if any liabilities are to come up, there is insurance and there is a clear liability. Perspective that would be applicable. Regards to from this session. Thank you for being here, Michuki.
Enough for that. Make some active. Around about 40% of the people and that extend a landscape does become expensive. And all the other to sort of meet the, all the other costs that will need We've seen to 600. That are initial benefits we are seeing with this technology in the LEOs operators. Of $100. So if you add the or 8%, it's putting it comes with this with respect. By local they hire their overheads and they hire their to be discussed at the local level and the national level. The regions are becomes and you know give the satellite as opposed to each provide simplify lower costs and the other thing that value we are seeing suddenly be helpful. Audible. Some of the discussions around been backhauled. Then there are other policy considerations that need to do have policy So to these, then single subscriber models. Affordable or so those are things that we need to broad base markets that react
Thank you. Thank you very much, Michiki. To be quite honest, that are all the points that we have the law is there. For the big remarks. But we have tested. You might wish to Brilliant. North American region, you have the leaders in technology. Are these issues being addressed? Floor is yours.
Okay, I'm going chair, but I'm RNOM. And geosatellites, like a LEO satellite, will gather stationary satellite, which will then broadcast it back. Two companies that are doing low Earth orbit satellites, Telesat and Eutel. I'm not sure how you even pronounce it, Eutel. SAT and OneWeb, which I think are merged now, they both operate geostationary satellites today, and of course they're building out LEO constellations. OneWeb and SpaceX have demonstrated low Earth orbit to aircraft integration already, and SpaceX Starlink is already marketing consumer and maritime connectivity. The previous speaker said that everybody's focused on consumer. To date, both SpaceX and all the others are going to branch out and cover other markets as well. See that. Perhaps this MOML network to it. And here it's the hybrid space. Unit so far. For this country, and that is we'll keep all this together. It's owned by just the underserved users, like we're talking about here. And then there are five other contracts that are military related for battlefield. Bottom line is these companies have been tasked to demonstrate what they. And a couple little notes. SpaceX is committed already, so much committed to what they're doing that perhaps they wouldn't be willing to. Amazon and the final thing is that this DIU and HAS, they're totally ARPA Advanced Research and Research Projects Agency, and of course the ARPANET, which we've obviously okay. It's LEO-based internet access, and the I'm going to look at four challenges. Order of I wrote some And the reason is these satellite constellations, they represent a very large investment and fixed cost. The marginal cost exists, and it for example, for the kinds of enterprises that were mentioned before, capacity is a really dynamic thing. SpaceX capacity today is not going to be their capacity tomorrow. So. Light's capacity goes up. As was mentioned before, and a lot of SpaceX, their version two. All certainly SpaceX is going to deploy all of them, and I think all the other vendors will too, and that in itself has time, and they're that something more interference and so the one Russian hackers who are wanted by the defense against the Roman. In 2011, only 1% in 2 competing mobile companies to come.
acting on behalf of a I would like to kindly say that would diligent respond give do, however, more
I'll take them. Honorable Riatile, a member of the how optic fiber. Particularly, let's say we talk about a population of 200. The type of speakers. Thanks.
Okay. Might indeed be recommendable for us to collect the three questions.
Yes, my name is youngest commissioner of Iran so far. Discussion. See two different perspectives on etc. It was online platforms like social media, etc., the U.S. is more advanced. Of U.S. and more easily, so those.
Of geopolitics there as well as orbital. One question, is it Roberto, do you want to put a question and then we'll go back to the speakers for responses. Thank you.
Thank you. With the cost and also with the capacity, I mean, the speed that we I think we may be solving the capacity. To continue to be a problem in the future. Is there any expectation? Second question. Assignment. And I can particular allocations for particular applications, and of course, it would prevent us to actually access to this kind of services. Is there in low orbit satellites that are
we will hand the floor over to further speakers
sure.
as we progress. Dan, yeah. Thank you.
Great. I know those are some great questions are there. If I had that correct. And fiber than you will out of to. So I think questions around, you know, launching who owns to launch its own system? Probably not, you know, but who does control it, right? Of different entities in different places around that kind of thing. And then the other major players is planning to launch in early 2020. Constellation coming, or the EU just mentioned wanting to get wanting to put one together there. There's actually Constellation. From other North American or European dealing with the IT as when you get the allocations, you have to meet certain deployment guidelines. You have to have 50% of yours up and 100% who's the it's more countries will be consumers of these other spoke about, which is, you know, how do you are you only that mean to be addressed by groups, multi policy issues. In our paper that the United States or in somewhere it, I will spectrum assignment. Has established various different spectrum contacts in particular for LEO satellites are already in use by their military and national security and other elements like that. And so for SpaceX to be, you know, there's have to look at how to a whole host of questions on that I'll leave it to my other panelists now, Joanna.
Well, I'll start with the question regarding the EU. So Joanna and I equitable access, we mentioned that it's not desirable to have one nation, one constellation in space. You know, the question should constellation, but existing infrastructure in a when we consider the EU's mitigating the is not EU authorized out a backup system, strategic the regulations most of these also you have the alternative one way more. The regulations changes the requirements of international, you know, you have nation, and it's a forum organizations but all the correct forum to address I'm willing to deliver.
Few minutes. Many thanks to merely an link to the ISOC report that Dan has mentioned on a number of occasions. insight. Wish to reach out. Joining us. Might feel very so I will is a topic. So right now we are leaving you with a recording and a report, and hopefully looking forward and fast internet. Thank you for pretty much the session is concluded.
For thought it was worthwhile, and thank you for the